Maybe it's because I'm rewatching Adventure Time at the moment, but I'm getting some major Lumpy Space Princess vibes right now. I'm Abby Esparza, this is Photo Manipulation, and we're going to jump right into it today. So I did record myself extracting the model, but frankly, I really took forever on it, mainly as a means to procrastinate, and it's not very interesting to watch. The more boring stuff I cut out, the less I have to crank up the speed, and anything over 1600 times speed is a kind of garbled mess in my opinion. It was just me taking my sweet, sweet time masking out the background with a hard round brush. Ever since getting my Cintiq, a hard round brush and a layer mask has slowly become my go-to means of extraction, beating out the pen tool a majority of the time nowadays. You definitely don't need a screen tablet to extract images like that, but I could never manage to do it with a standard tablet. That's more about my inability rather than the possibility of you doing it. Most people can do things that I can't do. I did, however, leave in how I did the hair, which is just a quick and sloppy select. Then I hop into selected mask and hit refine edge, and then a round of hand masking, which has been my process for years now. To add more hair to both the top of her head and to the main body of hair, I used copies of the same model's hair set to lighten. When you have darker areas that need more detail, lighten is an excellent option. It works well on hair, but also on things like beefing up foliage to make it look thicker and fuller. Things like grass and bushes. That being said, all this effort ended up being pretty much wasted when you consider how intense the final backlit hair becomes. When the edges of your hair are just flat white, you can just paint in basic hair shapes, which is super easy to do, whether it's hand painting or using hair stamp brushes, which I used both here. Honestly, this whole image is kind of an excellent example of wasted time and bad choices, which is fine, it happens. My whole missed goal here was to try and perfect this neon hair gig, because I really like the idea, but my execution is always off. I do technically have a tutorial for it, but I kind of wish I would have held off on it. I've been told by people who are much more talented than me that they just couldn't get it to work, and I'm not surprised because it's super finicky. But you're welcome to give it a shot. I'll link it down in the description if you're curious, but it's still a pretty half-baked effect. Cute, but it needs a lot of finessing. Which is what you end up seeing here. There's a lot of back and forth with the hair, as well as things like the background. God only knows how many times I switched between blue, pink, and orange for the background. I still don't know which one I prefer. At one point, I wanted it to have this like heat wave vibe, so everything would be like squiggly, if you know what I mean. So you see me messing with that. And in the end, I did my new favorite thing that I do when I don't know what to do, but I just need things to look better. Add glitter. Glitter, highlights, shiny bits. She ends up looking like a cross between Jim and the holograms, and like I said, a lumpy space princess. I don't know why I get that vibe. Maybe it's the pink skin. Which again, I'm pretty okay with. She may be ultimately a failed image, but yeah, she's kind of fun to work on. And through all the random stuff I was just throwing at the wall, hoping something would stick, and nothing did, but I did think of some pretty fun future concepts, mostly involving glitter. Definitely wish I had the time to fix her lighting situation. That's a whole mess. Don't worry, I know. But sometimes you just have to throw your hands up, rub some glitter on your midriff, and call it a day. That's what we call art imitating life. Before I go, because no one wants to hear me talk for 20 minutes, I have super awesome news. Neostock, our very own resource site, is having a killer buy one get one Black Friday sale. If you buy one stock bundle, you'll get a second completely free. It's only going for a super limited time, now through Monday, so you definitely want to get on it sooner rather than later, because it likely won't exist later. Link down in the description.
Thank you.
I super sadly lost about 30 minutes of footage, but it was just more glitter added to the skin using the same techniques as the jacket. And to turn the skin pink, I just very lightly masked the neon hair group onto the skin. It was all a very last minute decision. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. More proper how-tos are absolutely on the way, and I hope you guys dig the big buy one get one sale over on NeoStock. If you want to check out more of my work and hear my nasally voice ramble about this, that, and who knows what else, you can check out my Berserk video. More blood, less glitter. I'm Abby Esparza with PhotoManipulation.com. See you next time.